God's word, I'm going to pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of thy holy child Jesus, we thank thee for thy word. Thy word is truth. Thy word is alive. O Lord, we pray thy truth would come true in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Once again, in John chapter 14, verse 12, Jesus Christ promised, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. Because I go unto my Father, how does that help us do his works? Verse 13, and whatsoever you ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you should ask anything in my name, I will do it. Christ will do it. Jesus will do it. He is alive. He's at the right hand of God. And when we pray in his name, he does it. That's how we can do the works of Christ if we believe, like the disciples did. At first, they were scared. Yes, you may be scared. It's okay. The disciples were scared. But after Jesus rebuked them, they believed. And when they believed, they did the works of Christ. They went forth and preached everywhere. The Lord working with them. Years ago, I was traveling back to Bangkok from Esson. I was very tired. We had done a lot of walking that trip, and a lot of preaching. Different villages. And on the bus, the nighttime bus, I was ready to sleep. From Mesa to Bangkok, all night long, I was going to sleep. I bought the bus ticket, and I asked for the very back seat. The back seat. So I can sleep in the back and wake up in Bangkok in the morning. I was very tired. I've been doing a lot of preaching. A lot of walking. I was ready to sleep. The seat next to me was empty. The seat next to me was empty. Nobody's sitting there. Praise the Lord. No. Because a man saw my seat was empty, moved to the back and smiled at me. He was one of those kind of people. He was that kind of person. He liked men. And now he's sitting next to me. I don't like that. Makes me uncomfortable. Uncomfortable. Not happy. So I moved up to another seat. He followed me. Sat beside me. I told him, I'm going back to the back. If you follow me, I'm going to punch you as hard as I can. So I went to the back seat. But now I can't sleep. Because I'm concerned. I'm worried. He may come back while I'm sleeping. So I stayed awake all night on the bus. In the daytime, no problem. I can read the Bible. But at night time, there's no light. There's no light. All dark. So I can't read my Bible. So I have to sit on the bus for the whole ride to Bangkok. We get to Bangkok. I'm very sleepy. Very tired. I get into the taxi. I tell the taxi where to go. And we drive off. I want to rest. I want to relax. But that taxi driver, he needs Jesus. And I've just been preaching all different villages. I need to preach this taxi driver too. If a person to preach to big crowds, if you personally preach a lot of people, but won't preach to that one person, that's not a good preacher. Not only preach to the big crowds, we have to preach to that one person as well. So I begin preaching to the taxi driver. I don't even know if he's even listening or not. I just keep preaching. He keeps on driving his taxi. And I'm preaching about Jesus. How God answers prayer. How Jesus saves. Preaching away. And I don't even know if he's even listening to me or not. We got closer to where we're living. He stops the taxi. Oh no. This has happened before, where taxis would tell me to leave. Get out. So I'm thinking he's going to kick me out of the taxi. He turns around and says to me, I don't believe easily. I will not believe easily. But I owe a lot of money. To mafia. To bad people. It was money. And by 12 o'clock today, I have to pay a large amount of money. I don't have that money. If I don't pay it, they're going to kill me. And hear you are talking about God answering prayer, Jesus alive. He says, I don't believe very easy. But if what you're saying is true, and it works, and it happens, I will believe. I said, perfect. We got to where I live. He took me where I live. And I prayed for him. He said, it's impossible to make that much money in one day. But he's driving a taxi because he didn't know what else to do. God does the impossible. If you believe. And God enjoys to do the impossible. When Jesus walked this earth, he never said, another problem. Oh, I'm getting tired of you people.
No.
He enjoys to do the impossible. God enjoys to answer our prayers. It makes him happy as well. It makes him happy. When you pray for the impossible, the Lord smiles. He can do it. He says, nothing is too hard for me. So I prayed for this man. I wrote down my phone number. And I told him, when God answers prayer, please give me a call. I'd like to hear about it.
Sorry?
I would like to hear about it. If he doesn't answer the prayer, call me. I'm going to throw this book in the trash can. He said, like that? It's going to be like that? I said, it's like that. Either God is true, or he is a liar. I believe he's true. Went to my room. Praise God, my wife fixed me a nice food. Ate the food together. And finally got to go to sleep. It was so nice sleeping. That was a long bus ride. And praise God, I'm safe in my room. Can now sleep. And the phone rings. I answer the phone. It was that taxi driver. He began saying, I believe. I believe in Jesus. I said, what happened? He said, right after I sent you, I picked up a person who hired my taxi. To pay for the taxi. To go from Bangkok to Suphanburi. Wait there. And then come back to Bangkok for the exact amount we prayed for. The exact amount of money. He says that never happens. But it happened that day. For the amount of money he needed. Because God answers prayer. Jesus, who died on the cross, rose from the dead, is with the Father. Because of that, we can pray in his name, and he will do it. Anything we ask in his name, he will do. And this is how we can do the works of Christ, like the disciples did. In Acts chapter 3 again, we see the apostle Peter. He tells a man in verse 6, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee. And the name of Jesus Christ Nazareth, rise up and walk. Peter did not have silver or gold. Peter didn't have money. But he he had something else. He had the name. The name of Jesus. That when he prayed in that name, the Lord did it. Because the Lord says, if ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. And the apostle Peter prayed. He prayed for the man to rise up. And the Lord did it. The Lord healed that man. Because of that, the apostle Peter preached. And 3,000 souls were saved that day. That easy. How? Because he prayed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We can do it today.
Amen.
We need to do it today.
Amen.
We need to see 3,000 souls saved today.
Amen.
Jesus is coming again. We need to get souls saved. And how did the apostles do it? They prayed in the name of Jesus. And when the Lord answered prayer, souls were saved. There's missionaries. There are missionaries who have a lot of money, and they say Thailand is impossible. They say the Thai people is too hard. Many give up. Many go home. Because money is not the answer.
But
you believe in the name of Jesus. That if you pray in his name, because he's with the Father, and he will do what you ask, you can do the works of Christ. Back in America, there used to be an old Chinese man, Bill Yi. He was never happy. His wife loved Jesus. Bill Yi did not. His wife would praise the Lord. He would just sit there. His wife liked to take Christians out to eat. His wife liked to take Christians out for lunch. Eat lunch. And while everybody's talking, he would just sit there. Not happy at all. Would not say a word. Wouldn't talk to anybody. He didn't like Christians. He didn't like church. His wife did. His wife did. His wife loved the Lord. But one day, Bill Yi became a preacher. Smiling. It wouldn't stop talking. He had died of cancer. And the church we went to, the pastor of that church, 85 years old, prayed for Bill Yi. And he came back from the dead. And he came back from the dead. And he began preaching to everybody. The same man that wouldn't talk. Wouldn't stop talking about Jesus. And in church, he was loving Jesus now more than his wife. How did God change that man? Because God answers prayer. What you ask in his name, he will do. Because we're so good. Because he's at the right hand of the Father. He's there for you. He represents you. And I can pray in His name. And God will answer. It's the same as if Jesus asked. Whatever Jesus asked the Father did. And now He's at the right hand of the Father. For you. To pray. And anything you ask in His name, He will do. And as He does it, when He does it, then we preach the gospel. And people listen and believe. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank Thee for Thy word. And we pray, O God, that what we've heard from Thy word would come to pass in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.